Thanks for coming out. We are the Marvin Windows Capstone team. We are specifically tasked with creating our own intuitive asset management application. My name is Cameron Ethier.
I'm Nicholas Cooker.
I'm Monica Zimmerman. Cameron Roldy is our fourth member, but she's unable to make it today. So the overarching goal of our project is to create Marvin's asset management system, management software. And we're creating a web-based application using React to create this. And there's three main focuses of our project. The first is to enhance usability and performance. Our application is going to be used across several departments in Marvin once it goes live. So you want the application to be intuitive to the employees on the production floor, the business analysts, and anyone else who may be using our application. The second one is to configure all of our information to be stored under machines. The current application use, the information is stored under the users or the employees. So in order to see a machine, you have to search by employee, and then the machine data is stored underneath them. So this has led to some fragmentation of data, and it's harder to search to find the information needed. And the third one is just to give Marvin's asset management software a more intuitive and modern look and feel. We've had a few projects to look at to base our design off of, and we're just modernizing the designs used. So some of the problems we're solving in the current application use is that the old product, as I said, was user-based, so a lot of the information was fragmentized. So we're moving all the information to be stored under machines, so just allowing them to see the whole picture. And the other issue was data was split amongst several separate systems, so information for the machines was not only in the application, but it was also in Excel files and batch files. So the goal of the application is to have all of the information stored inside this one web-based application, so that's minimizing the amount of times that users have to leave the application to go see other information. So this is the current client management system. As you can see in the left top corner, you search for users, and that populates the screen. So the machine information is in the bottom right, and then there's more information about the network the machine's attached to and the devices for the machine. So our design is going to kind of do away with the user information and show just the machine information and this information about the machine parts and the department they're under. So it allows you to get a clear cut view of the information that's needed and do away with the information that they won't need. We also had a previous capstone design project to go off of. So this capstone project had a similar design to ours. Everything is based under the machine instead of based upon users. So we'll have a similar setup with how information is shown, but we're modernizing this design. Input tables will look newer, and then our actual application pages won't be simply a table. We're going to have things more clearly laid out, and we're going to do away with the file hierarchy. It'll look more like an application you would see today rather than a older Windows application.
All right. So as the previous Capstone group had already done essentially a proof of concept, we knew that what we were hoping to do could be done. A large amount of our focus was then instead adapted towards making our displays intuitive, dynamic, and ultimately giving a better user experience. So due to that, the first few weeks of our project were focused specifically on making mock-ups, getting specific designs, and ultimately seeing what things we like and don't like about our designs. So on screen here are two of our initial mock-ups done within the first 2 weeks. You can see across the left side, most of it is going to give the user ability to choose what they're sorting by, change what they're filtering that data by, and ultimately choosing if, let's say, if they wanted to sort by a specific vendor, they can choose from that vendor. It'll display some information of the vendor, as well as populating the data with only information attached to that vendor. If the user were to select a specific item, it'll go ahead and populate information across the top, giving images, data, or any specific relevant information about that specific machine. Across the right side here, you can see a very similar display, just made by one of our other group members. This one is by Cameron. You can see it's essentially the same thing, just ultimately a slightly different layout, so giving a different feel for how maybe somebody else might have looked at it, so we can see maybe what things we like or don't like about each design and ultimately tailor that into our final design. And then you can see another one of our initial designs here, and you can see that they're all based on a similar design, so they're all running a tabular display. This one is actually multiple tabs, so you have a sub-tab inside that you can choose to navigate within. But ultimately, it is doing the same thing. You're having the same types of tabs, the same types of information displayed, ultimately just arranging things a little bit differently to give a different perspective on things. So as we move forward, we were able to be a little more specific with the information we're putting on there. So as we move past our initial designs, we were able to choose more of what specific data do we want to display to our users. What kind of information about each machine should be displayed there? Should we just have a name? Should we have the specific installation date, who it's by? All that kind of stuff is where we were able to start diving a little bit more deeply into there. We were able to choose to be a little bit more specific with our layouts, so we're able to get as much data within that space as possible without it being, you know, cluttered like the current design is. There's almost too much going on with the current one, where you didn't want to make it too simplified, so it's a good balance of both. We also had a little bit of time to play around with how we'd like the data to be edited, so we actually have the edit field currently within the dropdown, so you kind of see as it goes along with our design scheme, we're able to actually change our design and make it a little bit more intuitive as we went along. And finally, move on to where our current design is. So this is actually going to be closest to our current implementation. So as you can see, we were able to start adapting in the standards of Marvin Windows themselves. So we're able to start putting their colors in there, their logos in there, and ultimately starting to get a design that will be a little bit more with the standard of the company as opposed to just a simple mock-up. We also chose to simplify things a little bit more, so instead of having too many tabs across the top, it's really narrowed down to two. So simply machines and devices. Machines being ultimately a pretty simple display. You're only choosing by vendor, as it's a fairly limited number of vendors to choose from, so we didn't want to overcomplicate things by making too much search options there. So choosing simply by the vendor you'd like to select by, and then it will go ahead and populate information with each machine specific to that. And then on the devices display, this is where it gets a little bit more specific, since there are going to be a lot more devices, as for each machine, there's multiple devices. So this is where we choose to have the vast majority of our data and a much more complicated searching and filtering system. So you're able to filter based on the device type, the model, and even the machine itself, as opposed to just based on the vendor. So with that, we also have more information on each item here. So this is where you're able to see the vast majority of the information within each item, as opposed to just a couple basic fields. You're also able to navigate to editing the items here as well, as opposed to just viewing them. And then lastly, we do have the third tab, the configuration tab up top. So this is where a lot of the actual editing or the behind the scenes work will be done on any of those items. So let's say a new machine's put in place and you're going to replace an old machine. You're going to have to delete the current one. So this gives you access to delete or create new entries, so you can remove a current machine from all the tables or replace it with a new one.
Right, so our work started with a series of preliminary design deliverables, culminating in the creation of a series of mock-ups that the team felt best encapsulated the look, feel, and workflow that best served the user base at Marvin. We presented those mock-ups to the team at Marvin, and with their guidance, created a final mock-up that served and continues to serve as our guide for the project. We quickly got to work on a pair of prototypes, one using raw HTML and CSS to demonstrate the basic layout, and one in React to begin working with our front-end library, a semantic UI. These prototypes were shared with Marvin, and we discussed them alongside our sponsors to come up with final layouts and workflows. With the approval of our sponsors, we took the parts of the prototypes that we wanted to keep and began work on the application itself, adding to its functionality and bringing it to the state that you'll see here in just a few minutes when we demonstrate it. We've made some changes to the mockups along the way, as continual testing and demonstrations with Marvin have caused the product to evolve in ways that we didn't expect outright. The product that you'll soon see represents the most recent iteration of that continuous improvement, and though we'll continue to improve it after this midterm as the project begins to close, we're pretty pleased with how it's turned out so far, and we're excited to share it with you all. Our team has had to deal with relatively few setbacks and complications over the last 6 weeks, but a few events have taken place that we think are worth mentioning. The first major disruption we encountered was the birth of my daughter. I won't call her a setback or a complication by any means, but needless to say, it took me out of the project for a few days. But the other members of the team put in overtime and took care of everything while I was gone. Even outside of this project, I'll always be personally grateful to all of them for covering for me during that time. Later on in development, during the mock-up phase, Cameron experienced a failure of his primary hard drive, which led to a significant loss of work for him. Because we did mock-ups individually as kind of a brainstorming and prototyping exercise, there wasn't much the rest of us could do to help him recreate or recover his work, unfortunately. But through a couple days of hard work, he was able to remake a lot of what he had lost before we presented our mock-ups for review. This project has introduced our team to a number of technologies and frameworks for front and back-end development that we were all previously unfamiliar with, which has been a really great experience for us. With that, though, comes a learning curve. which at times has been an obstacle to productivity. We've mitigated a lot of that through creative problem solving and relying on each other's experiences and helping each other search for solutions. These setbacks and complications certainly impacted project work, but with some problem solving and determination, we were able to overcome them, and we've remained on schedule. I think Cameron's going to tell us more now about where we go from here.
Yep, so as we move on from here, we do still have a few things that need to be implemented and adapted from this point on. Primarily, we have to implement our actual delete functionality. So going ahead and implementing the delete button that will remove an item from all of the tables as opposed to just one, ensuring that there's no gaps in data or any future errors that might come up due to improperly deleting an item, and making sure that somebody can't accidentally go ahead and delete an item that might actually need to still be there. As well as that, we'd like to implement improved search functionality. So what we have currently is a pretty simple place to start from. We'd like to adapt and make it a little bit more dynamic and a little bit more involved for the user to make sure that they can find the machine they're looking for without having to scroll through 50,000 entries to find that one item that they need. And on top of that, we'd like to finish the program and ensure that the look of the application is something that's going to meet the standards of Marvin Windows. We want to ensure that it's something that they'll be happy with when they open it up and don't feel the need to change everything just to make it something that they're content with. And moving forward as well, we do also have a primary stretch goal, and that is to implement a mapping system that will integrate with our program here as well. Currently, there is a mapping system that's basically just a CAD drawing that basically lays out all of the machines within the manufacturing plant. What we'd like to do is make a slightly more interactive one that is a little bit easier to navigate for a user as opposed to having to drag around. They can simply click on the machine they want and bring them right there. Could also be something that would be implemented within our program. So next to that machine that you're looking at, you can just click on the little map and it'll show you where in the manufacturing plant it is. So allowing users to just pop it open, see where that machine is, and they can walk right there as opposed to having to do a whole bunch of searching to find that one item they're looking for. And then moving forward from there, we do also have a kind of a simple time layout so you guys can kind of get a feel for what all we're looking to do. So currently, March 10th, we're doing our midterm presentation. Thank you all for being here. From the 11th to the 6th, our goal is to complete our application in a basic sense. You'll get everything rounded out and finished. From the 6th to the 13th, this is where our testing phase is going to take place. So testing, debugging, and fixing any errors or issues that we come across along the way. From there, from the 14th to the 4th, this is where we'll be implementing our stretch goals given any time, as long as we're not overrun with any bugs or issues we have to fix. This is where we'd like to start implementing that mapping feature. And from there on the week of May 4th, this is where our final presentation will be given, as well as the submission of any of our documentation.
Perfect. With that, I will run through a quick demonstration of the technology that we have here. So this is the localhost version of the asset management system running inside of Visual Studio with a local database. We're going to be looking at the machines and devices pages. The configuration page doesn't play super nicely with the local database. It's my understanding that it works well using the production database back at Marvin, but it tends to cause some crashes with some table inconsistencies with the local version. So we'll stick with machines and devices for now. Again, our intent here is to keep it as simple as possible. You have a vendor selection here. This list is pretty small right now, but if it were to get bigger, you do also have the ability to search by typing in this box just to make selection a little bit easier so you don't have to scroll forever. Selecting the vendor then pulls up all of the machines associated with that vendor. Again, once our stretch goals get implemented, the intent is to be able to go straight to mapping from here if you want to find that machine or to be able to see some basic information or even edit information as well. Moving over to the devices tab. We're currently able to search by device type. PLCs are a pretty common one. So selecting that allows you to see each device, the machine that it's associated with, the firmware that it is running on, its serial number, information like that that can make replacement of a bad device or troubleshooting or even just finding specifications for the design of a new device that much easier. That concludes the demonstration portion of our presentation, as well as the kind of slideshow portion. Are there any questions?
Are there any of the machines made up of multiple machines?
Those would usually be considered devices then. The answer is generally yes. I mean, most machines have multiple components, but that's kind of what the devices tab is for.
You wouldn't, if you were deleting a whole thing made up of parts.
Right.
You would do them individually.
The intent here, the reason we don't have delete implemented yet, is because of that. When we delete a machine, we want to make sure that all the devices and the network information, everything throughout this database gets updated accordingly, so we don't have any stale information left over.
Yeah, no, a large thing is the fact that the database is made up of quite a few tables as well, so we want to ensure that we're actually grabbing the entry for every single one, as opposed to just accidentally deleting it from, you know, just the devices table or just the machine table. There's multiple tables tying each of those together, as well as tying to different components you might not even see here. So just making sure that we'll actually implement it correctly as opposed to quickly.
Yes. Any other questions?
Are you planning on adding features to add machines and devices?
Yes. Yep. That. Thank you for asking that. I believe the configuration page, which again I'm not going to demo here just because it isn't playing nicely with our local database instance, is where that'll take place. Yeah. Any other questions? Yeah.
What is the difference between a user and a machine?
Sure. So users existed kind of in the past, from my understanding, as a way of organizing information based around a series of Windows accounts, which my understanding is worked well at the time. But with machines all falling under users, it made finding an individual machine a task of having to understand which user it was under first, which for someone who wasn't around at that time, maybe would be a little bit more of a searching exercise than would be optimal. Any other questions?
With the application itself, how hard would it be to add additional search features to, say, the machines category?
To the machines category, not hard. Again, the intent with this draft was to keep it as simple as possible, just to kind of help modernize from the very complicated views that we had with the previous application. But again, like we mentioned, this project is definitely evolving continuously as we go along, which is great as we continue to get feedback from all the different users at Marvin. So if the user base thought that more filtering and searching options were optimal for the machines tab, then I think that would be something we could definitely do.
And that is the main goal for our next sprint, is to build up a better search function for the pages.
Yeah, especially the devices page, kind of finishing that up. Yeah.
Yeah, I noticed you guys mentioned what you're using for the back end. You want to talk about that a little
bit? Yeah. So we mentioned React because everybody likes to talk about React. The backend is actually Active Server Pages. It's a C# ASP backend, which admittedly was new to me as a React user. I think new to most of us, kind of seeing those two things come together. I'm used to seeing React work with Node or Express, but it's worked very well. I think it integrates well with Marvin's existing infrastructure. I think a lot of their applications are using ASP, and it integrates well with Microsoft SQL Server as well. Yeah, hopefully that answers your question.
Thanks, sure.
No. Thank you very much. We can thank the folks at Marvin for those. Perfect.
Thank you.
Yep, thank you very much.